you can see, we have two microphones out front because I'm about to introduce you to two very talented performers. It's always a great pleasure to welcome them back because we never know what to expect from these guys, which are completely unpredictable. Some of you may have seen them recently down in Atlantic City, and others of you may have seen them in concert tour with Tony Bennett. Tonight, they're the stars of our show. Will you please greet with a nice round of applause? Here they are, Alto Mantia.
Just a couple of guys with class. We're up to our elbows in class. We all very suave with them and there, I'm sure you'll agree. Whenever we felt, we always do it in pee. A couple of stylish jokes. While dining, we don't pick our toes. We don't make your jokes on how the farmer's daughter was made. Which we won't tell no matter what we were paid. Our chassis is so classy that we
song. I'm sorry. Lynn, I have to ask you a question. In this sketch, Bob is going to play a French lover. Is he a good lover? I hear a lot of giggling back there.
I don't hear nothing. I see guys nodding yes.
Be careful, will you please?
Okay, we have a beret for you, Bob. Put the beret on. You're French tonight. You're suave. Put the beret on and take your pants off. And then we'll see why they call you Big Bob. That's the front door, and you knock with the knocker. What we tell you, okay? We'll explain everything as we go along. It's really simple.
Bob, in the sketch, you have one line. The line is your name. Whenever you hear me say, "Who is it?" yell your name real loud so the people in the back can hear you. Got it?
Now he's getting cocky. We'll see. Okay, what this is now is kind of a takeoff of a soap opera. We'll see what happens. We call it the Edge of Confusion. Oh, good morning, darling.
Good morning, dear. Breakfast is almost ready.
Oh, no, I'm sorry, sweetheart. I'll have to skip breakfast this morning. I'm late for work.
But I just buttered your muffin.
Oh, sorry, dear. I got to rush to the office. I'll call you later. Goodbye, sweetheart.
That must be my French lover, Robert. Who is it?
Bob Mager.
Yes, we got Julio and Lazy over here. Bob, don't play with your knocker over there, will you please?
Darling, come in. My husband just left, thank God.
Straightening some things up, darling.
Are you hiding something from me?
Hiding?
I know there's someone in that closet. Now, who is it?
Robert!
We gotta start all over.
You said there isn't, you know. That's why he said his name.
Yeah.
I
made
a mistake. Yes. Come here, Bob.
Come here. Sorry, you were right, Bob.
Come here, sir.
When he's right, he's right.
Come here, Bob. Don't worry. It's all right. He made a mistake. You go over there and get your knocker. Go ahead. No, you can't write a check.
Look, Bob, okay, you got it?
Here. What? You play the wife this time.
What's the matter with you now?
I don't want to play the wife.
Why?
He grabbed me.
I'll play the wife. Yeah, maybe. You're making a production out of this thing. Can so we just do the sketch?
I'm ready.
I'll play the wife.
All right, good.
What should I do with it?
Hey, now.
Who is it?
It's Bob.
No shit. Come in.
Do you have a rash or something? I don't know. I'm funny there.
Sweetheart, my husband just left. Thank God. Oh, it's my husband. Hi. You know where? Yes. Good.
Nothing,
there's no one in this closet.
Are you hiding a bunch of factors?
Think of the honeymoon.
Darling, I'm going to stay home from work today. No. You and I together, just like it was in the old
days. Hold it, you're right, the part stinks. I can't wear the wig.
Well, I'm not going to wear it.
Well, somebody's going to wear it.
You catch on quick, don't you? We know that wouldn't be fair. We're not going to do that to you. Come here. I promise you, we are not going to make you wear this ugly-looking wig.
No, we're going to make you wear this wig. And now, folks, I wish that Washington was in D.C. I don't know. It's in Jersey.
From Jersey, he is.
Breakfast, and you're cooking eggs benedict. Okay, cool. sweetheart, you ugly water bucket.
I gotta go to work. Sweetheart, you and I to get gutted too soon for this. You know, you look like Boy George.
Last
Well, I'll tell you the reason he said that. Bobby quit smoking in January, hasn't had a cigarette since January,
I'm sure a lot of you have been through it. You know, when you quit smoking, the tendency is to eat a little more. I gained 109 pounds since last Thursday. I live in Grand Union now. Aisle 3, the cookie aisle. I enjoy myself there. I live next door to Petra's Farm.
You see, that's what he said, cookie out. He eats junk, and that's why he ate the weight.
What do you
if
want?
You stop smoking, you eat regular. You
yeah, but I eat. You leave me alone. I eat.
Did you ever hear the expression, you are what you eat?
I'm a Twinkie.
Do you want
to Twinkies. Oreo cookies. Oh, with the milk. You dunk them until the bubbles go out.
Somebody else likes to do that too.
Yeah.
Then you drink too much coffee, you make you nervous.
What do you want from me?
Yeah, the sugar is worse.
I don't use sugar.
What do you call it?
Donuts. Chocolate, preferably, glazed, anything. Whatever's available.
But you can't keep donuts.
No, I know. I'm going to lose weight and I'll be able to do the impression.
Yeah, well, it's ready.
Oh, it's ready. The impression's ready. I worked it out with Bob and the guy.
He's been working on this impression for the last 2 weeks.
Like 2 weeks, right?
Yeah.
Well. Could you have an imagination, could you imagine I'm 60 pounds thinner?
What do you want from that?
I'm 60 pounds thinner. No, it's not that big of a deal. I will try it.
Want to do it?
Yeah.
All right.
Don't get excited, ladies. Here's the sexiest singer in the world, Tom Jones. Picture called Strange Love. It's going to star Bo Derek and Lassie. Hey Bob, you can paint a tree in this one if you want.
And I must die.
gentlemen, if you will, help us to thank these fine musicians behind us, Bob Grosso and his orchestra. Please give a big hand.
You can't miss Bob. He's the one with the red tie. In 1939, MGM produced a musical that, well, throughout the years has become an American classic. It was called The Wizard of Oz. I'm sure you've all seen this film many, many times on television with Judy Garland. And it's such a wonderful picture, you just never get tired of seeing it. It's our favorite movie. So, tonight, we would like to show you our version of The Wizard of Oz in Italian. She's walking along the road. All of a sudden, storm clouds darken the sky. And the wind, she starts to turn into gale of bulls.
Thank you.
come to see the wizard.
Wizard, see?
Oh, no one can see the wizard. I can't see the wizard. There's no wizard here. Who told you the wizard lived here?
The munchkin.
Those little lion bastards. Get the hell out of here.
Over here. Over there. Over
going, you know. Keep rolling and rolling.
We're old men riverman.
Bob, you see these napkins that we threw? We didn't tell you about this part. You got a vacuum cleaner back there?
Yeah, we thought we'd hang out a little while, you know, fool around.
Kind of maybe get acquainted if you have anything that you'd like to ask or anything, any questions you might want to ask. If you do, we'd be glad to answer. A lot of people ask us if we're married. Not to each other, but married. Are we married?
Well, yes, I'm married. I have two kids, but he's not married.
I have six kids. And we write, we do, people ask us a lot, we write all our own material. And the answer to that is yes, we do. We write everything.
Before, when I said cocky doody poo poo, I wrote that. That's my line.
If there's anything else that you might want to ask us, you can feel free to do so. What is it? Are we related?
No,
not related.
Please.
Well, not really, no. We're just friends. And people ask us how we met.
I found him in bed with my wife. Sort of sense.
Kind of related.
No.
Actually, we met when I was a singer and Bobby was...
I was a belly dancer. San Susan.
Right.
Remember that joint?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, it happened. Well, 12 years ago. I don't know how long
it was.
Let's get out of there alive. I didn't sing all right then. Well, we knew him both were singing.
Yeah.
Yeah, but he's a singer. He's okay, I will. Thanks. Athletic.
All right, I'll
sing something from the Guns N' Roses room. What about the Indiana the Goldberg in the Temple of Beth Israel?
As a matter of fact, I have a new song that has only been performed twice.
I've done a warm up closet.
This song was written by a musician that works in the Catskills, and he sees comics every night. He's been in love with comedians his whole life. He just loves to watch them. And I do too. I love comedians. I don't consider myself a comedian. I'm a singer, I guess. I started as a singer and I've had the good fortune to be working in comedy, but I'm not really a comedian. And so I understand how he feels about comedians. So he wrote this song about comics. And I think I'll just sing it for you. It's about the people that make us laugh.
You're the kind of a winner.
I can sing too, you know.
Yeah. Now that's true. There's good. Bobby does sing all the harmony parts. He writes all the harmony parts for the stuff that we do.
Packs.
Harmony packs.
If I could sing that song, it's a
Newly
song.
It sounds like a Newly song. It sounds like variant they do it, but
anybody can sing like Newly.
Yeah?
Sure. Just don't pronounce anything. Stick your tongue out. I wrote a song way back in the 50s. 50s is my era.
Oh, that was some good stuff.
You know, and I used to sing lead. I used to go in the subways with the echo. All the guys, you know, sing harmony.
Yeah, that was fun. I remember.
Would you back me up on something? The 50s song.
Alright.
Just give me a bell G. I mean, G. And the beep, beep. That's your part.
That's my part?
Yeah.
It's going to sound naked like that.
Good.
Would you help me? Would you back him up with me?
Yeah, everybody said.
Yeah.
Would you do that? Simplest thing in the world to do.
Give me that G and P. Okay, here's our part. Part of Davis. Give me that GP.
I'm doing
yourself somebody to love.